one and all to the season of great joy when young and old alike embrace the joy of the season.
Oh, except one, William, and that would be our dear Mr. Ebenezer Scrooge. He doesn't have time to waste on the joy of the season, or for any season for that matter.
Well, and there he is, the devil himself.
He robbed from the widow and swindled the poor. In his will, he left me enough money to have him buried. But I buried him at sea. Yeah!
Good morning, Mr. Scrooge.
Cratchit, what are you doing with that piece of coal?
Just trying to pull out the ink.
You used that piece last week. Now get on with your work, Cratchit.
Speaking of work, Mr. Scrooge, tomorrow is Christmas, and I was wondering if I could have half a day off.
Christmas Day? Well, I suppose so, but I'll buy you a half a day's pay. Now, let's see. I take you 2 shillings a day.
2 shillings and a half penny, sir.
Oh, yes. I gave you a raise 3 years ago.
Yes, sir, when I started doing the laundry.
All right, Cratchit, get busy while I go over my books and... Here's another bundle of shirts.
Thank you, Mr. Scrooge.
Let's see. Oh. That's 50 pounds of interest compound daily. Money.
Merry Christmas. And Merry Christmas to you,
Matthew.
Merry Christmas, Uncle Scrooge.
What's so merry about it?
Uncle Scrooge, Christmas is time for giving, for being...
What's so merry about it, I say again? I'll tell you what Christmas is. It's just another work day. Any guest happy to tell you anything else should be boiled in his own pudding.
Uncle Scrooge, Christmas is time for giving, for being with family, for...
And I say, Father.
And I say Merry Christmas.
Well said, Master Fred, well said.
What are you doing, Cratchit?
Just warming my hands, sir.
What are you doing, Brad?
I came to give you a wreath and invite you to Christmas dinner.
Well, I'm supposed to have a plum Christmas goose, plum pudding and candied fruits.
Yes, will you come?
Are you daft, man? You know I can't stand that stuff. And now I'll with you and take your wreath with you. Humble.
Can I say Merry Christmas?
That Brad is always a good kind of
person. He was always a little cute. What can I do for you two ladies?
We are soliciting
for the what?
We're collecting for the poor.
For the poor. When you realize if you give money to the poor, they won't be poor anymore, will they? And if they're not poor anymore, you won't have to raise money for them anymore. And if you don't have to raise money for them, put you out of a job.
Well, I
don't ask me to put you out of a job.
Remember me when I was alive? I
swindled from the poor,
and robbed from the rich.
But I was poor!
You can't. As a punishment, I have to carry the
Oh, spirit!
Why would the ghost of Christmas present want to harm a mean little miser like you? Especially when there are so many things to enjoy in life. I am the spirit of goodwill and generosity, which you have so long denied your fellow man.
Generosity? No one has ever shown me generosity.
You've never given them reason to. And yet, there's some who still find enough warmth in their hearts for the likes of you.
No acquaintance of mine, I assure
you. You'll see.
What's happened? Where is this place? Why did you conjure up this shack?
This is the home of your overworked and underpaid employee, Bob Cratchit, and his family. These are his wife and children.
Here, Betty, help me take care of him. Yes, Mother. Oh, what a wonderful Christmas feast we shall have. I'm so very excited.
What's she cooking, the canary? Certainly they have more food than that. Look on the fire.
It's your laundry, Scrooge.
Shall I fix the stool for Tim, Mother? Is there anything else I can do to help? Is it time to eat, Mother? Oh, you famished. All these wonderful smells make me quite anxious to eat.
Not yet, children. We must wait for your father and Tiny Tim. Christmas is a time for families to be together. Isn't it wonderful?